My name is Holly Grand. I work with Texas Parks and Wildlife Department's Coastal Fisheries Division. I am our outreach and education coordinator, and we are out in the field today. We're doing our one of our first days out in the field where we're getting to show you guys what we actually do when we are collecting some of our field samples and stuff. So I'm really excited about that. I'm not here by myself today. I can't do what we're going to do here today on my own. So we actually have two of our staff members here today that I'm going to introduce you guys.
How's it going? My name is Braden Gross. I'm a technician with the Upper Laguna Madre.
I'm Chaz Downey. I'm also a technician here in the Upper Laguna Madre.
When we arrive at our site, there are a few things that we need to do first, including collecting some information about water quality. So we've got Chaz on the side of the boat. He's got our YSI. He's going to stick that probe into the water and get a reading for the temperature, salinity, or how salty the water is, and how much oxygen is in the water, or our dissolved oxygen. And then he's going to read that off to Braden, who's going to write that down.
Yep. 15.4 Celsius, 8.8 for PO, 31 for salinity.
Gotcha. All right.
So we collect this data at every, pretty much the first thing that we do when we arrive to any site. And we will collect that information, write it down. And then we also collect a water sample that we will take back to the lab, where we can use another type of meter to see how, measure the turbidity or like how much stuff is in the water. So with this sampling, we do this this type of sampling year-round, all 12 months of the year. We have a set number of bag stains that get collected at each field site. We collect 20 samples every month. Half of them get collected in the first half of the month, half of them in the second half. So we're not really going to bring any of the vegetation back with us, but we'll bring back a lot of the, we'll bring back all of the fish that we catch and just make note of the different types of either seagrass or algae that we're finding here to record later. So it doesn't look like we've got a lot of different things here today. It looks like we've just got a lot of fish, one type of fish, I think. So there are some days where we'll catch a lot, like a lot of animals, whether that's a lot of shrimp or other different types of fish. And then there are some days where we don't catch anything at all. So we've got these measuring boards that we use to measure our fish. It's just pretty much a box with a ruler inside of it. And we will use that sieve to strain out all of the water that we were using to keep the fish alive. We typically like to start measuring with the fish that we have the most of. So in this case, it's going to be a lot of sheep's head minnows, but we do have a second species, which I'm super excited about. So we'll go ahead and measure these sheep's head minnows first, and what they're going to do is try to get. So we try to measure from snout to tail, and we get the measurement in millimeters. And then from here, pretty much what we do is pack up and head out to the next location.